What is School Car?
School Car is a virtual program designed to help operators understand our procedures when operating in multiplayer runs.
Why do we have School Car?
Previously, members, also known as operators,
don't follow procedures given by the dispatcher. Some examples of infractions caused by operators are overspeeding in areas that are speed protected, passing red signals without authorization, opening doors on the wrong side of the track, using Control J, and the worst one of all, operator-to-operator collisions, known as derailments.
We are serious about our roleplay events because it speaks about the group in many ways. We also want to have fun, but we can't do that if the runs end early due to train operators not understanding the rules. Remember, it takes a lot of effort to put together an event, and if other members can't participate, it ruins the fun for everyone.
Keep in mind, this is a mandatory class. You must participate, understand, and pass before entering any verified OBND multiplayer runs.
In order to pass School Car, you need a 70% or higher. Any grade lower than a 70% will result in you taking the class again or reviewing the materials that you need the most help in.
We understand everyone is busy and don't have the time to do the training. However, if you missed a class or need to be trained before the official release date of multiplayer, please reach out to us on our communication platforms, such as the OBND forums, OBND Facebook page, Discord, Teamspeak, or email. A verified dispatcher or OBND coordination member will set you up with the information and class as soon as possible. In OBND School Car training, we have four main objectives you'll be involved in to understand how we do multiplayer operations. Of those are School Car rules and regulations, radio communication, train operator procedures, and signaling rules and regulations.
In School Car rules and regulations, you'll be taught the procedures on how to participate in our events and the proper guidelines to follow in the event something was to happen in the roleplay that may require you to write a statement. In these guidelines, we expect all of our members to follow and to adhere to these rules so that the run can start early and end at a respectful time so that other members don't get affected too much by the inconveniences. Radio communication. To maintain order in our runs, we added this course to our objective because we feel some operators don't know how to communicate properly to their respective control centers.
2250 Charlie, radio check.
2250 Charlie, radio check. Loud and clear to the RCC.
10-4. Do I have a lineup out of 168?
Yes, we have lineup out of 168. Please give me a call back at 145th Street.
145th Street for the 2250 Charlie, 10-4.
Sir.
Communication is a vital function of train operations. If you can't communicate to your control centers correctly, you may be the cause of the run ending early due to miscommunication. But since you're in training, we will help you build the confidence needed to speak to your respective dispatchers to get the message across effectively to prevent any issues. Train operator procedures. These are the rules that we follow as train operators to govern us so that we can move the train quickly and efficiently. An example of our train operator procedures is the following. Rule number 2. All train operators will stop at their respective stop car markers at all times. This means that all trains, unless otherwise instructed by the RCC or your local tower, will stop at every station they are supposed to in order to pick up customers. Another example of train operator procedures will be Rule 16. If your exit signal does not allow you to proceed out of the station, do not close down and creep up to the signal. Keep your doors open and await instructions from RCC or your local tower. Last but not least, signaling rules and regulations. Besides the dispatcher, another system of governing trains is called signals. These are the traffic lights for trains that guide them to speed up, slow down, and hold at a signal if a train is in front of them or if a signal has a malfunction and can't be cleared completely. In this objective, operators will learn all the procedures for operating under different signal types, the procedures on bypassing defective signals, and understanding their posted signs and their meanings. An example would be 10 miles. This sign is indicating to the train operator that the speed of the train should not exceed 10 miles per hour in this area unless otherwise posted. Another example of signals will be reverse running 25 miles per hour. This means that if the train operator has a reverse instruction given to them, the train operator must operate their train at no more than 25 miles per hour unless otherwise posted.
It is your responsibility to properly interpret signals before moving over them. Never expect the signal to turn green.
In conclusion, having fun and being professional is at the forefront of what makes OBND, OBND. It has been its DNA for 8 years and counting.
We have made a lot of history, and we at OBND take a lot of pride in that and hope that we continue to grow to new heights in this community. OpenBVE Multiplayer is something everybody has been waiting for, and we want to make sure that this new milestone is something that everyone in our community can take pride in and enjoy. We believe that school car is what will help us achieve that goal.
So, do you have what it takes to join our runs?